Peanut Northwest. It is $146,250.
There's the amount.
So bid for Intermountain Slurry Seal Inc. is $199,290.
And then the last one's from Maria Prado from Second.
So bid from BSS International Inc., $136,500.
What's it called, BSS?
BSS. BSS International.
So you will make sure that those are all responsive bids and tabulate them and come back and let us know who the winner is.
Sure.
See you in a week or so. Next item on the agenda is citizen participation on agenda items only. Anyone have any questions or comments on agenda items, now is the time to ask those. Please step to the podium and state your name for the record.
Kat Stone, and I have a question about two of the items. Number five is a contract on behalf of the county with Oregon Timber Counties Coalition. I Googled them last night. I can't find them anywhere. Who's on the board? Who's their chair? How many members? And why do we need a contract with them? And number 11 is parks, and we're going to change the name of the county fairgrounds, and I just wanted some of the rationale behind that.
Since I've been here, Douglas County's done their U.S. Forest Service policy work through the Association of Oregon Counties Federal Subcommittee, Federal Land Subcommittee. The AOC Federal Subcommittee is no longer going to be in existence, and there's a group of counties that wants to continue to work with the federal government directly on U.S. Forest Service management of their lands and a secure school payment program. So this particular company, Jamison & Sullivan, has been the vendor that's been doing that work for AOC. So a group of counties, including Douglas County, came together and decided they wanted to continue that contract. As you all know, the amount of money we get from secure schools off the Federal Forest Service land is the second highest in the nation. So of the 700 counties that receive Skuro school funding, Douglas County is number two on Forest Service land. If you add ONC and Forest Service together, we're number one. So this issue is no more important no more important than any other county than ours, so we need to be a part of this. But this is a coalition of counties coming together, really, that are counties that have these U.S. Forest Service timberlands in them that want to continue to do this work. So we'll continue that contract with this particular firm. Again, they've served us well. They have over 30 years of experience. And since I've been on the board here, they've been the firm that has been doing that work on behalf of the counties in Oregon. So I'll move to approve the contract.
I'll second.
We have a motion second for questions or comments. I appreciate you coming up with an alternative. So thank you. Call for the question.
Yeah, a group of counties did that. What just me?
Right. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Crest?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number six is a county council ordinance amendment. Mr. Meyer.
Thank you. Paul Meyer, Douglas County Council's office. So this is ordinance number 2020-06-03. So let me read the heading. It's an ordinance amending sections 12.08.170, 12.08.180, 12.08.190, 12.08.210, and 12.08.350 of the Salmon Harbor Ordinance and deleting 12.08.020 and 12.08.040. As I said, this is ordinance 2020-06-03. Today's the first reading. Second reading will be scheduled for July 22. And if you adopt the ordinance at the second reading, it will have an effective date of October 26, 2020. So briefly, last week you signed the agreement to terminate the intergovernmental agreement with the port. The joint management authority set forth in that intergovernmental agreement was also described in the Salmon Harbor Ordinance. So what these changes do to the ordinance is to simply replace the references to the Salmon Harbor Management Committee with a reference to the Douglas County Board of Commissioners to reflect that you'll be managing that department directly from here on out rather than through the Salmon Harbor Commission.
It's just first reading, right?
Yeah, first reading, no action today.
No action necessary. And we do have, by the way, a place on the website where these ordinance amendments are listed at least between the first reading and the second reading, if not sooner. So item number seven is an HR item, authorization to pay. Mr. Van Dyke, good morning.
Good morning, Commissioners. Paul Van Dyke, Human Resources Department. You have before you a set of invoices which need your approval for payment. The invoices are for renewal of the county's major insurance policies. You have an invoice in the amount of $49,353 for renewal of the excess workers' compensation insurance policy. An invoice for $132,067 for renewal of the county's excess liability insurance. An invoice in the amount of $4,143.30 for renewal of the county's crime insurance policy. And last, and certainly not least, an invoice reflecting a dramatic increase in the cost from last year of renewal of the property insurance policy. That is in the amount of $222,554.95. In addition, there's one invoice that doesn't reflect the renewal, but a request for the board's approval of acquiring additional cyber liability insurance for $10,550. That will increase the amount of insurance that the county has for cyber liability. We already have some as a component of the property insurance policy. This will increase the amount, and the amount, the increased amount will not be a shared limit, which is the case with the coverage we have currently for cyber liability.
We move to authorize the payment of invoices.
Second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? No, it's not my insurance bill. Go out of insurance. Call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Crest?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number eight is land easement agreement modification. Mr. Houston, good morning.
Good morning for the record, Rocky Houston.
Director of the Land Department. In front of you is a modification of right-of-way easement to Douglas County and Champion Timberlands and Champion Air National Corporation. Essentially, there's a change in ownership, and as such, we're trying to make sure our easement matches the current owner.
We'll move to approve the easement agreement modification.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Dugan?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Thank you. Item number 9 is also land of permit of entry.
This permit of entry agreement is between Douglas County, James Gill, and Champion Creek Ranch Incorporated. This is going to allow the county to go out and address some tree removal and finish repair. The permit of entry expires August 15th, 2020.
Move to approve the permit of entry.
Second that.
I'll add a comment. This is actually a remnants of work that's due because of the snowstorms. So before we change the land ownership out there, the land belonged to us, and trees from our side fell down and damaged Mr. Gill's fence. We have made an agreement with him to go in and replace that fence. This is just doing that work, so we're going to get it taken care of. Call for the question, Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number 10 is the Lipstick Grant Agreement. Good morning. Melissa, how are you?
Good morning. Good. Long time to see fellow commissioners. So, should I keep my mask on? Okay. This is a grant funding from the Criminal Justice Commission, $50,044, to support the Lipstick Coordinator position between April 2020 and September 30th, 2020. This is the Criminal Justice Commission in 2017 got grant funding from the federal government to hire 6 Lipstick Coordinators statewide, including myself. And they have leftover money from that federal grant that they need to spend down. So one idea was to give it to some of the Lipstick Coordinators that are still employed through that program. And so they are offering $50,044 in this grant. No strings attached, just quarterly report requirements. It's reimbursement based. And yeah, happy to answer any questions.
We'll move to approve the grant agreement. Thank you for your work on this and as the coordinator looks at.
Thank you.
I'll second that.
So a motion and a second. Just one quick comment. When we, when that program officially ended, and we looked at the valuable work that you've done for us in helping to organize and streamline our operations that are related to Lipstick, and Douglas County made a decision to try to hire you for ourselves full time, there was a challenge in trying to figure out where all the funding was going to come from. And we knew that we could account for the majority of your salary through administration fees from other grants, but we were going to be short about $27,000, I think, the first year, and a little more than that the second year. So we were going to have to identify other opportunities to fill that gap. So this money has certainly taken care of that for the first year and the majority of what we were hoping to find for the second year. So thank you. With that, I call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes.
Thank you.
Item number 11 is parks, and it's a park designation. Mr. Houston, and welcome back.
Good morning. For the record, Ron Houston, Parks Director. In front of you is park designation pursuant to ORS 275-320 for designating the real property outlined in the Exhibit A as a public park to be known as Douglas County Fairgrounds, RV Parks, and Campgrounds. This is not the entire fairgrounds. This is a portion of the property, which is the RV park and the restroom associated with that RV park. What this allows is additional resources to be available for operation and maintenance of that facility to help make it better for the public. This is not a financial burden upon the Parks Department nor the fairgrounds.
Park designation.
I'll second that.
Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Item number 12 is a public works item and contract assignment. Mr. Havers, good morning.
Good morning. Scott Adams, Public Works. This is an assignment with CB Pacific in Douglas County to upgrade computer software in Galesville Dam. It's assignment number one of a contract that was implemented a couple weeks ago at a previous board meeting. This is for installation and upgrades to computer software at the dam for the SCADA system.
We'll move to approve the contract assignment.
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number 13 is public works agreement. Scott.
So again, Scott Adams, Public Works. Item number 13 is an agreement between Douglas County and Wildlife Safari to chip seal the Safari Road.
Second that.
We have a motion and a second. When's that project, the chip seal part, start?
Probably happened towards the end of August. So we're going to focus on getting through town and up to the north section, and then we'll revisit it. We did some patching in April on that. We kind of want to let that oil cure out before we get back there. So we're going to get it towards the end of the season for chip seal season.
Great, thanks. Call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number 15 is another public works contract. skipped 14. Okay. We're on 14.
Again, Scott Adams, Public Works. Item number 14 is contract number 3000381 between Douglas County and Guido Construction to provide traffic control flag and services on as needed and on call basis.
Move to approve the contract.
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Now we're on item 15.
Scott Adams, Public Works. Item 15 is a contract number 3000387 between Douglas County and Bexcel Imaging for an annual subscription for DDP large government base. DSB resolution imagery and premium post-catastrophic imagery. So basically this is our aerial imagery for the whole county. There's a component of this that is inside most of the limits. It's a little bit more detailed than outside. This feeds our total GIS network, which probably more than 50% of the departments use. Quite a better price than some of the others that we've researched and looked at. Both assessor office and also have been detailed and trying to get a good price for an imagery for the
county.
Second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments?
Just a quick comment. Thanks for the work on this. Thanks for getting me there with it. And I also want to thank Heather for the research. She actually found that saved the county part of the money.
Call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number 16 is the Public Works item, purchase of real property.
Scott Adams, Public Works. Item number 16 is an order accepting a warranty deed from the Fennell Ranch LLC to install and maintain the emergency temporary detour bridge on South Myrtle Road over Myrtle Creek. Purchase price is $861.61. This should be the final step in this whole process. Apologize for how many steps we've had to get through, but this should be, as long as the owner is good with this, we will be implementing it and going away.
We could approve the purchase of real property.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
There will be as well. Motion passes. Item number 17, Public Works order authorizing purchase.
Item number 17, Scott Adams, Public Works. Item number 17 is an order authorizing purchase for traffic striping paint under the statewide cooperative purchasing provisions. The cooperative purchasing provisions of competitively bid contract with the Deschutes County Road Department and NS Flint Incorporated. total price is $356,812 for 41,250 gallons of white and yellow paint.
We'll move to approve order authorizing the purchase.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Item number 18 is a surveyor item. It's a plat map approval. Good morning. Surveyor group, how are you? Good group.
I am well. What item number 18 is a land partition plat at the South Umpqua Industrial Park. And it's in front of you for your signatures representing Douglas County as owners of the property. By state law, the owner has to sign the partition plat. So we're dividing the one parcel, 29-acre parcel, into a 6-acre parcel and a 23-acre parcel. So.
Great.
Can we approve plat?
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments?
Yes, sir.
Any
comments? I was just going to suggest if you change the name of your department to a surveyor instead of just surveyor, you'd have gone first instead of last.
Is that what I have to do to get on first? Okay. I didn't know that. So anyway, your signatures do have to be notarized by, but you have notary in house, so.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. I'm not going to take an intermission today, but I'm going to make sure that everyone who wants to speak can sign up real fast. Is anyone on the list? Anyone not on the list wants to be on the list? We got one speaker signed up. Cat Stone.
Cat Stone, Roseburg. I just, it came to my attention that you have a new IT guy. Things are kind of held up in the public records request department. And I wondered if this new IT guy can figure out conceivably how to have video of these proceedings and store them without enormous cost on something like YouTube, and to get the live stream back up for Reedsport. This is a basic standard of government. It isn't out of the realm of possibility, and we don't look good if we're not providing it.
Commissioner comments?
Nothing to do.